Hey guys, and welcome to Retro Recipes Off Menu. So occasionally there are going to be some electronic things that we need to do that are not necessarily retro, but still may be of interest. So that explains this new series. What explains this episode is this. This is my Pentair Intelliflo pool pump, and it's developed quite a common problem. There's a lot of posts on forums from people asking for videos on how to fix this, so that's what I'm going to try to do. As you can see here, sometimes the LCD display can freeze, sometimes it can turn off completely, but the pump will still work. Now, some people say this is down to moisture getting in or corrosion, but it seems that on the forums, people are finding that this is actually due to a loose connection in the LCD display, which you can fix using a pretty simple method. Now, before we get started, you are going to need a very specialist tool. Now, I know nobody's going to own one of these, so I'll put a link below the video to Amazon where you can actually purchase one. And this is it. It's called a Phillips head screwdriver. And that's what we're going to need. So let's get started unscrewing. Now, I was being funny about needing a specialist tool, and then I just realized that I need a specialist tool. This actually requires a Torx screwdriver to unscrew the remaining four screws. I guess I will put a link below the video where you can obtain a pretty cool little kit of those. Now, interestingly, or I should say annoyingly, these service screws actually have an additional pin in them, which prevents a standard Torx screwdriver going in. It's no good. All right, we're gonna look for an alternative. Hold the line. What we can do is use some sort of a saw or Dremel. Unfortunately, my Dremel's out of action, to make a line across the head, and then we can use our flathead screwdriver to unscrew it. You ready for the new saw movie? There we go. This would be easier with the panel still screwed in. Okay, and in case you're wondering what this little thing is, this is called a microbot push, and it's a Wi-Fi enabled robotic finger pushing button that I use to start my pool pump using Google Home or Google Assistant. Now, obviously, before you open this up, do make sure the power is off and disconnected. So now we're going to try to lever off this cover. There we go. And then what we can do is disconnect this. Just slides out like that. Okay, so welcome to my workbench. What I'm going to start with is cleaning this up with some rubbing alcohol. Okay, so while that evaporates, let's see how we get into this. It seems to just be self-adhesive, and I'm going to just peel it around the edges so that we can pull out the whole panel. So once you've removed the adhesive just around the edges, you can then use a little screwdriver to leverage the whole panel out. And look at that, there's a little RS-232 plug in there. Cute. All right, set this aside. Should be able to unclip these. Some more clips on the edges here. Just give those a push. Now, an easier way is just slide the screwdriver into the cavity there and then push inwards, as I realized near the end. Okay, set that aside. Now, what I understand from the forums is that there are a few things that can happen, corrosion being one, and indeed we do see corrosion there. So the question is, how did that get there? That's between button one and two. They are watertight. Can't see any way water would penetrate. Ah, well, if we look really closely, there's a little crack on the speed one button there. One on three as well, though. Either way, I'm going to look into sealing these. So first things first, I'm going to get a cotton swab and my alcohol spray. We'll just go to work cleaning these traces. Okay, so just spray a little alcohol. That gunk comes right off. Don't see any lasting damage. Traces seem okay. Let's dig a little deeper, get inside. Just pops off its little housings, its little feet, just there and there. Okay. Looks good to me. What I did see was that this was quite loose. And indeed, when you read online about this, this is the conclusion most people come to. Is that this connector does get loose from the LCD screen. So first up, I'm going to use some WD-40 contact cleaner. So this is very specific for cleaning contacts, which is exactly what we have here. Dab that down a little bit. Well, you'll find that it just evaporates. So, put that back on the LCD. Yeah, you'll see that it's quite springy. And they did put these two things here to help push it down when you put the panel on. What people have been doing is using insulation tape or insulation foam and actually lining the edges of this just to help add even more pressure. I'm just looking here again, that corrosion. Seems to have gotten under this switch. Maybe I will take these off because it's going to stand out less if it's grey. Now, while I've got the contact cleaner, I'm going to just clean these switches. I think we can clean the inside of our screen. May as well add some more double-sided tape to this area. Snap this back into position. And that foam is going to put pressure downward onto the screen and stop this springy contact shenanigans here. That feels really firm. Let's help some of these in. Make sure they're all in really tight because the foam is trying to force them out. That now feels really solid. Let me get my alcohol clean where the adhesive's gonna go back. Hey, on this goes. Stick that back on. And then what I had planned to do is just cut around this once we knew. Pull that off. Very nice. Well, let's go try it out. Okay, so there's a teeny tiny something. Pull that taut while I screw it. I think at this stage we should just test it out. Voila! It's a little hard to see in the daylight, maybe under the ziplock, but we now have a display. Now the other issue before was the buttons were not working at all. So let's try those. Try our robot finger. The problem seems to be fixed. I screw the remaining screws in. I'm gonna say goodbye. Thanks for watching, and I'm gonna leave you with the beautiful music of my pool pump fully working. Please like, subscribe, and share this video, and I'll see you next time. Cheerio.